Trust your first impression. What do you see down there below you?
Leaves.
What do you see?
Leaves.
Leaves. Mm-hmm. I see leaves.
Brown leaves.
Brown leaves. Very good. What else do you see around you?
Some little trees.
Mm-hmm. Little trees. How close are you to those leaves? Are they below you?
I'm just standing on them.
Mm-hmm. So as you're standing on these leaves, look down at your feet.
I'm barefoot.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that you're a male or female?
Male.
Male. Mm-hmm. So I want you to just observe your body. If you want, you can wrap your arms around it to feel it. And tell me, what does your body feel like? Are you old? Are you young?
I'm about 40.
Mm-hmm.
I'm cold.
You're cold. Can you see how you're dressed?
Not much.
Mm-hmm.
Just like, I don't know, it's pants or trousers of some sort made out of something.
Mm-hmm.
Very like lightweight.
What else are you wearing?
Thin shirt.
Mm-hmm.
I'm cold.
You don't have shoes?
No.
And you're outside.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell what your features look like?
Kind of a blonde, sandy hair.
Mm-hmm. What is it that you're doing out there?
I'm just staring.
Mm-hmm. Describe to me everything that's around you.
It's just skinny trees and...
Skinny trees. Mm-hmm.
And nothing, just quiet and
mm-hmm.
It's like it's deserted.
Mm-hmm. What's your surroundings? Do you feel like you're in open space or forest? How does it feel?
It's a forest, but it's not real dense.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Might be near a swamp.
Near a swamp. Very good. Can you move in that place?
Yeah, I just walk.
Okay, so let's walk somewhere. Is there a path? Or are you just walking randomly through the forest?
Just walking around.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure where I'm going.
Mm-hmm. I want you to connect with your emotions. Go deep down into your emotions and tell me what you're feeling as you're going through this forest.
How did I get here?
Mm-hmm.
What do I do?
Do you feel that this is a place that's familiar or unfamiliar?
Not familiar.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where I came from. It's like I just got there.
Mm-hmm. So let's walk a little further and see what other relevant things you see in this place. You can look around and anything that you observe, just relay that to me. If you see any animals or people?
No, just seems to be the same for as far as I can see.
Mm-hmm.
All around me.
I And what's the weather like there?
It's cool.
Mm-hmm.
No sun.
No sun?
Mm-hmm. Is it dark?
No.
It's just...
like... cloudy day.
A cloudy day. Very good. Okay. We're going to close that scene now. Let's close that scene.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to go back in time.
Mm-hmm.
Find yourself going back in time to find out how it is that you got to that place. Go traveling through time and space.
There's people arguing.
Mm-hmm. There's people arguing. Tell me who they are.
I think it's the mother and father.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
And how do you fit into the picture?
They're arguing about me.
Mm-hmm. How old are you?
2
How do you feel? Are you young?
I'm like maybe between 9 and 14.
Mm-hmm. So you're like a preteen?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So what's the argument about? Let's listen in. Connect with them. What do they say?
My father wants to take me somewhere, and she doesn't want me to.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
Now I have a headache.
Mm-hmm.
I have a headache now.
Mm-hmm.
It's too hard. I can't listen. My ears shut down. I can't see.
So let's find out what's causing that headache. I want you to focus in on it. Focus in on that headache. And tell me what color that headache is.
Like burgundy color.
Like a burgundy color. Okay. So as you look at this color, I want you to flood it with white light. Flood it with white light. And notice that as you flood the white light into this burgundy, discomfort begins to just dissipate. Flood it with light. The more light you put into it,
it's like I have an arrow or a bullet in my neck.
Very good. Very good. So let's go to that place and see how you acquired that bullet or arrow. Let's go back there. I want you to drift and float to that lifetime. And tell me when you're there. Where are you?
I'm like in a desert and something like a... something's dragging me.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what's dragging you.
Maybe it's a horse.
Mm-hmm. I want you to disassociate yourself from your body and see it from above, and you'll be able to tell me what's going on. What do you see below you? Are you a man or female?
I'm that boy.
Mm-hmm.
My neck hurts.
Mm-hmm. You say you're being dragged?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see how you're being dragged.
It's like Some men are guiding this horse to drag me.
Mm-hmm. How are you being attached to this horse?
With a rope.
Mm-hmm.
It's a rope around my wrists.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what I've done.
What are they saying?
I think I'm mentally ill or retarded.
Mm-hmm.
And they're angry at me. And they're punishing me.
Mm-hmm. So follow the scene and tell me everything that happens. What are you saying?
I cannot say anything.
Mm-hmm.
I don't dare say anything.
You don't dare say anything?
Oh, no.
Mm-hmm. Tell me why.
Because I know I'm dead.
Mm-hmm. If you say something?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What is your name? What do they call you?
Something. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So what's happening?
They're angry at me because I'm so dumb.
Mm-hmm. What happens now? Where are they taking you?
The one man wants to drag me until I die, and they think my father picks me up and takes me back.
Mm-hmm.
My father wants to take over my care, and my mother's arguing with him. I don't know what to do. I don't talk anymore. I don't talk anymore.
Mm-hmm.
I guess I can talk, but it's not worth it.
Do you have any insignificant injuries?
I got the arrow in my neck.
Mm-hmm. How did you get an arrow in your neck?
Somebody shot me. For fun.
For fun. Mm-hmm. How did they shoot you? Through the back, through the front?
I was on the ground from the front.
Mm-hmm. When they were dragging you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And who shot you?
No, just the arrow. I think it was just an arrow.
Mm-hmm. Do you recall who did it?
One of the men. They're making fun of me.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
You know, I don't know what to do. I feel like I don't have any choices. I decided that it's okay to die.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have any choices. Everyone who has anything to say about my life wants me dead or wants to control me in some way where I may as well be dead.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm just so tired.
Mm-hmm. Who's around you right now?
Oh, the men with my father.
Mm-hmm. How many are there?
About seven.
And where are you right now?
On the ground.
Mm-hmm.
My father's negotiating to get me out. Take me back.
Mm-hmm. Is your mother there?
No. I don't know.
How do you feel about that?
I just don't know what to do.
Mm-hmm.
I have no choice. Because of the people around me.
So let's see what happens next.
think I just die of a broken heart.
Mm-hmm. So as you leave your body behind, I want you to tell me, what was the purpose of that life? What were you there to learn?
People are wrong about me.
Mm-hmm. Did you choose that to learn a lesson?
Even if I am retarded, it's no reason to kill me.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes I think I just wanted to experiment.
Mm-hmm.
To see if I could overcome there.
Mm-hmm.
Not understanding me. Oh, they understand me all right. They understand me. They ended up wanting to have fun.
Mm-hmm. And they used you.
And mm-hmm. I think I just learned that sometimes you're not meant to fight and win. You're not meant, because there are going to be forces that are stronger than you.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know. I didn't want to die. I didn't know anything else to do.
How do you feel now? Looking back at that life, how do you feel? Did you make the right decision?
So sad. I guess so. I didn't know what to do.
Mm-hmm.
What do people do? I think that's the way life goes.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes.
So let me ask you, what happened after you left your body there? Where did you go?
Oh boy, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
It's all cloudy.
It's all cloudy. Mm-hmm. So let's continue and see where you go as a spirit.
I think I said to myself, this isn't worth it. I don't know. I think I told my spirit not to go on.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't worth it.
Mm-hmm. So as you travel as a spirit, did you ever see the light? Did you ever go back home to the light?
No.
Mm-hmm. Where did you go?
I stayed there, and my spirit listened to me, and it didn't go anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
It just stayed on the ground. It's black. It just stayed on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, it doesn't feel like I went anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
The spirit, I mean.
So, when was it that you found this woman, Jane? When did you find her? How did you come across her?
Oh boy.
Tell me about it.
She She just made a contract with her mother.
Mm-hmm. She made a contract with her mother? Mm-hmm.
To be born.
Mm-hmm. And then what? Was her mother pregnant?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So where was her mom?
Her mother didn't care.
Mm-hmm.
She just wanted to be pregnant, so she didn't care. I don't know if she's... But I knew Jane... Oh boy, I knew she...
Tell me.
She wasn't gonna make it.
She wasn't gonna make it? Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Why is that?
She promised too much
mm-hmm.
to her mother.
Before she was born?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What did she promise her?
That she'd take care of her.
Mm-hmm.
But I
Whew. Tell me.
I knew her father.
You knew her father. How did you know her father? Did you have a contract with him?
No.
How did you know
him?
How
did I know him?
Did he use your spirit in any way?
He crushed my spirit at one time.
He crushed your spirit at one
yeah.
time? Mm-hmm. In a different lifetime?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you recognized him?
I wanted to tell Jane.
Mm-hmm. What did you want to tell her?
Ugh, who is she? I have... I told her that it's too late. She had to go through with it, but... She probably wouldn't make it the way she thought she would. I don't know.
And how do you know Jane in a spirit form? How did you talk to her if you hadn't gone to the light?
I know everybody. She was just there, I think. She was a... Let's see, she was a vulnerable soul.
She was a vulnerable soul.
And I did it because I could do it.
Ah, so you took advantage of her.
Yep.
She didn't ask for you, did she?
No.
And do you know that all souls have free will? When we come to this planet, there's free will?
Sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
You can't do it.
You can't do it. So you felt that she couldn't do this? Were you planning to help her?
No, because... Well, see, I knew that my free will couldn't get me out of where I was.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to tell her that maybe her free will would get her out of where she was, and but I don't know. I don't care if I didn't help her.
Mm-hmm.
Just wanted to tell her.
Yeah. So why did you remain with her for all this time?
But sometimes she's stronger than I think she is.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to prove myself right.
Ah, so you have a little battle going on with her.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What is it that you were called when you were alive? What was your name?
It's like Kuz.
Kuz?
Yeah, something like that.
Mm-hmm. Kuzba. And where is it that you reside in her body now? What part of her body are you affecting?
her left neck.
Her left neck, mm-hmm.
And her shoulder cap.
Mm-hmm.
And up to her left ear.
Mm-hmm.
In to her left jaw.
Why did you choose that area, Kuz? Is that where you were hurting?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Where was your arrow?
I left my neck at the collarbone.
Mm-hmm. The same place where she feels discomfort?
Yeah.
That's your discomfort, isn't it?
Yeah.
What else have you caused her? What other discomforts? Have you affected her psychologically? In the way she thinks?
She has. She does a lot of things.
Mm-hmm.
She has a lot of curiosity. And I can build like a little, kind of a little barrier around her so it thwarts her. So she gets started on something, and if I want to, she won't be able to finish it.
Mm. And what does that do for you when you get your way like that? How does that make you feel?
Like I have free will that works.
Mm-hmm. It sounds to me like you're trying to enforce some power that you didn't have in your last life. What do you think? You weren't able to do anything in that life, were you?
No.
No. So now you're doing it with Jane. What else do you do that affects her?
She grinds her teeth.
She grinds her teeth. Is that from you?
Yeah.
Why is that?
She's trying to get away from me.
Mm-hmm.
She just goes to anyone or anything just to get relief, but she she's lost the ability to think and reason what's great for her. But she's getting better, but it's a constant battle for me too.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
Because she's getting better at staying away from things that aren't right for her.
Mm-hmm. Like the alcohol and pills and things? And people?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Did you have anything to do with the alcohol? Or is that somebody else?
Must be somebody else.
Mm-hmm. So what else do you do for her?
I made her buy that house.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
Because she liked it enough, I knew she could push it over. I knew she could, I could push her decision over, and then Steve liked that house. And he's like me. He almost made her change her mind just to see if he could change her mind.
Mm-hmm.
But he liked the house. But there was a game in it for him, too.
What's the game for you?
Well, I helped him do it.
Mm-hmm. And what was his motive for doing it?
Oh, he's just like me. He feels powerless in his life.
Mm-hmm. So by doing that, he felt power?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And so did you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What else have you done to make yourself feel empowered with her?
I made her short.
Mm-hmm. And what's wrong with that?
She doesn't like that self-image.
Ah. Well, because do you realize that Napoleon was short?
Yeah, but look at the power he had.
Mm-hmm.
They name a complex after him.
Mm-hmm. Everyone uses their power differently.
She's short.
Mm-hmm.
Not pretty.
And that's your opinion, Kuz.
I could just mess with her a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I can do so less and less, so she got rid of Steve. She got rid of Steve. I never considered she could get rid of me too.
Mm-hmm.
Never occurred to me.
Mm-hmm. Kuz, it seems to me that
her car, I wrecked her. Her car, but then she got it fixed.
Mm-hmm.
And I had her battery dying all the time because, oh, I'm there all the time.
Mm-hmm. Is there anybody that works with you, Kuz, or are you just on your own?
No, pretty much on my own.
Mm-hmm.
The alcohol thing was somebody else, maybe.
Okay. But you've just been messing with her mind. Instability.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Lack of self-confidence.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Undermining.
Did you have anything to do with the fact that she's not ready to do her own sessions?
Well,
tell me about
that. As long as I keep her undermined,
mm-hmm.
she can't do much anything, can she?
No, she can't. Kind of reminds me of your past life. You weren't able to do anything, were you, Kuz? They hurt you quite a bit. You suffered.
You're kidding, they killed me.
They did.
And they you know what? They caused me to want to be killed.
Mm-hmm. And that's not very good, is it, Kuz? You weren't able to live your full life.
How dare somebody needle someone to that point?
Mm-hmm. You've been hurting a long time, haven't you? Everything you've done to this woman has been your pain, hasn't it? Instead of being able to go home to the light where you belong and feel the love of God. You've just been messing with her. It hasn't made you feel any better, though, has it?
Maybe you have some power.
But that power really isn't power. Because the most powerful thing there is love.
You know what? I found her father. Her father could really needle the shit out of her, too.
Mm-hmm. Did you help with that, too?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Kuz, would you like me to help you alleviate some of that pain? You've been hurting a long time.
That's all I have is the pain.
Mm-hmm. Kuz, how old are you?
Maybe 20.
Mm-hmm. When you died, were you 20?
No, I was 14.
14. And what year is it for you?
I don't think there is a year.
Mm-hmm. What year did you die in? Did your body die in?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. It's been a long time.
Mm-hmm. You've been looking a long time for that redemption, haven't you?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Kuz, would you allow me to alleviate some of that pain now so that you can feel relief?
Would you like me to help you?
I don't know. It's the only thing I have.
Well, Kuz, what I'd like to do is I'd like you to feel love. And the only way to do that is to take the pain away. And I want to send you home. They've been waiting.
I want to go home.
You want to go home, don't you? You've been making Jane want to go home all this time,
yeah.
Haven't you? It's been you who's been crying to go home. Mm-hmm. Kuz, I'm going to put my hand on your chest, and I want you to give me all of that pain. I want you to take every bit of it, all of the cords, all of the slime, all of the cables that you have in her body, and give it all to me. We're going to send it to the universe for healing. Pull everything out, all of that remorse.
But I won't have anything.
We're going to give you more in a minute. Trust me. Give all that to me.
But I'll miss Jane.
You won't miss her. You'll see her from the light. You'll be able to work with her. Isn't that better? You'll be able to help her. If you want to, you could be her guide. But you'll be coming from the light.
But I'm important to her.
Of course you are. But we can help her even better from the light, not by making her feel bad. If you want to help her, you want to make her feel good. Give me all of
care.
That.
I don't care.
Give that to me.
I don't care.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to ask the angels of the light to come in here, and I'm going to have them make you feel that love. I'm going to ask the angels to encircle you now, Kuz. They're coming around you. And I want them to make you feel that love of the light. As they encircle you, they're going to encapsulate you in this beautiful cocoon of light. And I want you to feel that love. And as you feel that love, I want you to give me all of that pain to lighten your load.
Bury me nicely.
Mm-hmm. You don't need to be buried. You don't need to be buried. You're going to go right to the light where you don't need a body. You'll be pure light. Give me your pain, your regrets.
I got a lot of them.
Ah, we'll take them all from you and send them to the light. All of your remorse for not having lived a proper life, for being dragged and killed in such a terrible way, being made fun of. Give that all to me, Kuz. You don't need that anymore. Give it all to me so you can be healed. And tell me when it's all out of her body. Give it all to me.
But you have to give me something back.
Of
I can't
course.
Give it to you.
I'm going to give you a lot more. I promise you.
I'll give you all I can because I don't know what...
Mm-hmm. I can't give you anything if you're full of all of that hate and all of those terrible feelings. How can I fit it? Give it all to me. Tell me when it's all out.
It'll be all out when you tell me what you're going to give me.
I'm going to give you lots of love. Love is the most powerful force there is. I'm going to fill you with light.
I
can't if it's full of darkness.
Well, they're just words to me now.
Ah, but you'll feel them in a moment. Because I feel all of this coming out of you now.
Big old pimple.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's pop that pimple and get it all out. And I'm going to ask my archangels to come and help you so that you feel safe. I'm going to ask Archangel Michael to come in and help. Archangel Michael, show Kuz the light. Give him that feeling so he understands.
where he's going. What does he tell you?
I feel he feels like he's going to be empty.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, please don't let something else come in.
Mm-hmm. Allow me to take all of that. Let me speak with Kuz.
Okay.
Kuz, are you ready to give it all to me now?
If Michael stays with me.
Of course.
Michael has to, I would trust it if Michael stays.
All right, Michael, please hold his hand. Okay. Put your arms around him and hold him as he gives it all to me. Feel his power and his love. And describe to me, Kuz, what it looks like to have all of this inside of her. What does it look like?
You mean the love?
All of the cords that you've had attached to her, what do they look like?
It's like brown string.
Mm-hmm. So pull them all out, Kuz. Pull them all out. Take them with you. Want them all wrapped around you, because once you go to the light, they'll all be dissolved. And give me all of those feelings that you've been holding for so long. The resentment, the anger, feeling powerless unless you do harm. Give that all to me. You don't need that anymore.
But what am I going to be?
You're going to be light. I'm going to have Archangel Michael take you right to where the light begins. Archangel Michael, take him so that he can get a feeling of what it's going to be like when he goes there. Take him there, but I want him back because he can't go there with all of this burden. Kuz, tell me what you feel and see.
Like I'm blinded.
Mm-hmm. How does it feel?
It feels okay.
Mm-hmm. It's going to feel even better when you go. So give me all of that that you're feeling. Give it all to me. We need to heal that. Trust in me. You've been hurt so many times before. I'm not here to hurt you. I'm a friend. I've sent you Michael.
You know. I have to have an angel with me.
Mm-hmm.
I don't trust myself.
Mm-hmm. So I'll do this for you. I'm going to ask my other archangels to come and circle you. Archangel Raphael. Archangel Gabriel, Archangel Uriel, and Metatron. These are all the team that I work with. I'm also going to ask to have Saint Germain come in and encircle you with beautiful purple light. Mm-hmm. And Coos, did you know Jesus when you were alive? Did you know of him?
No.
Did you hear of him? I'm going to have him come and meet you now. All of these are helping you. You didn't have any friends then. Now you have ascended masters and angels working with you.
Yeah, I don't feel so alone. It's nice. I don't want them to go away.
They'll go with you. They'll go with you.
I don't want them to go.
Once you get to the light, you'll meet your guide who's been waiting for you for a long time.
Maybe I can help my mother.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Would you like to see your mother again? Okay. You can't if you, as long as you stay with Jane. Give me your burden. May I take it now?
Yep.
All right. I'm taking it and I'm sending it to the universe for healing. Now, Coos, in that space, all of that empty space, what would you like to fill that with? It's your choice.
Peace.
Let's put lots of peace in. Beautiful peace. And I'm going to have to seal it here. Let's seal that. What else would you like to put in?
I don't want to feel lonely anymore.
Let's put a lot of wonderful feelings of being accompanied by all those, attracting those that will help you. Feel it. Friendship. Love.
I don't want to be alone.
Mm-hmm.
Let's I don't want to die alone.
Let's put all that friendship in there. Let's put friendship in there and accompany. Love. Do you feel it? Let's put it in there. What else would you like to fill it with? How about courage? Would you like courage to go up to the light?
And confidence.
Let's put lots of courage and self-confidence. Very good. Let's seal that. What else?
I would love myself.
Lots of self-love. Let's put that, fill it a lot. Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm so tired.
Mm-hmm. So let's do something now. I want you to tell Jane, before you leave, what you feel now that you know that you've hurt her all this time. Tell her how you feel about that. Do you feel any remorse?
I don't know. I felt like I didn't have a choice.
Mm-hmm. Would you like her to forgive you for that? For interfering with her free will? Because you can't leave unless you've been forgiven, can you? You don't want that load on you. Would you like her to forgive you?
I don't know what that means.
That means that you don't have to carry that guilt of interfering with her.
I don't feel guilty.
You don't feel guilty. All right, well, let me ask Jane how she feels. Jane, what would you like to tell Coos? Would you like to send him off with love?
I'd like my life back.
Mm-hmm. So what would you like to tell him? Would you like him to go off with the angels?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So tell him to pull everything out from your body, every influence that he's left there. Pull it out and take it with.
Go and take everything with you.
Mm-hmm.
I have to heal. I never... don't even know who I am.
Mm-hmm. You never had a chance, did you?
No.
Okay. So tell him that. Tell him to go in peace, with love.
Go with peace. Go with your bike. Mm-hmm. Go with your angels.
Mm-hmm. Let me speak with Coos now.
Okay.
Kuz, are you ready to leave?
Yeah.
Okay.
I guess so.
So, while you're going there, I want the angels to accompany you. Pull everything out of her body. I want you to pull it from her physical body, from her etheric body, her astral body, all of her bodies that she has, physical, non-physical, in this dimension, in any other dimension, in the past, present, future. I want you to pull all of your influence from her, any life that she's living now, parallel life. Pull it all out. We don't want anything left of yours in this being of Jane, in her consciousness. Pull it out. And now I'm asking Archangel Michael to accompany you into the light. I want you to leave out through her crown. And Archangel Michael, I'd like you to take him to the light. And Kuz, tell me if you see your mom there.
Yes.
Give her a big hug. She's been waiting for you for a long time. Thank you very much, Kuz. May the light of the universe accompany you always. Thank you very much. Now I want you to take a deep breath in. I want you to look at your entire body. I'm going to put my light from your toes to your head. I'm scanning your body with my hand. And your light should be illuminated. Your whole body should be illuminated with white light. Tell me if there's anything in your body that has a shadow anywhere where it's not light. Do a scan. See if there's any place that's dark. What do you see?
You talking to me?
Mm-hmm. Take a look at your whole body. Scan it.
Just my leg up to my right leg and all the way up to my right hip.
Mm-hmm. So I'm going to take my hand now. I'm going to scan this leg. I'm going to bring up the energy. I'm bringing it up, 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 past your hip, bringing it up. And now allow yourself to express this energy. Good afternoon. How long have you been there with Jane?
Since she was a boy. I didn't kick up until she was about 12.
Mm-hmm. Are you male or female?
Male.
Mm-hmm. What may I call you?
Moose.
Moose?
Moose.
Moose?
Yeah.
What kind of name is that, Moose? Where are you from? Where was your last life?
In the dark.
In the dark, okay. So you've been in the dark all this time. And how did you find Jane?
She made me angry.
Mm-hmm. How did she make you angry? If you were in the dark.
Let's see. She was too independent.
Mm-hmm.
Too capable of doing things.
Mm-hmm.
I needed her.
What did you need her for?
To have some constraints. I needed her not to move forward.
And why is that? Did you know her?
I think her father sent me.
Oh, her father sent you, I see. How did your her father send you? Did he have some sort of a ritual?
I don't know if it was a ritual. He would get himself worked up and get really angry. When she had a mind of her own.
Yes, that's free will and independence.
And she was very smart and clever. She was more smart and clever than him.
So why did he call you?
Because while she was young, he needed her to be stopped.
Why?
Because her brother was supposed to have everything.
Okay. So she had too much power?
She could have.
Well, Kuz was interfering too. She would have been more powerful without him. So what did you do?
There were a lot of, like, especially sports activities that she would do that I sabotaged.
Did she agree to having you join her?
She didn't know what was happening. She was too dumb.
Oh, I see. Because of Kuz.
She thought she was so smart.
Don't you think she actually was?
Oh, yeah.
So did her father make a contract with you? Or did he just create you out of his thoughts?
He just created me. Because I don't... I've never been in a body or anything. Energy.
So what else have you caused her all of her life? Besides the constraints?
Well, I caused a skiing accident. And that eventually led to her hip replacement. And now her knee's kicking up.
Is that you too?
Oh, yeah. And the veins and the bullshit and the... I mean, her right side... I also crippled her hand when she tried to write on the wood.
But she says that that stopped after a while.
It did, because she found out... She untangled.
Did she break a contract with you?
I didn't have a contract with her, but she had, in order to cope with everything, she developed different personalities so she could cope with different situations.
And which personality was the one that found you?
The smartest, most predominant one. The one that was going to get her ahead.
How many personalities does she have?
Well, there were three back then.
Describe them for me. What were they like?
The one where she was smart and alert. She kind of could have done anything. You know, she chose to be born at a time when women could start to do things in their lives.
That's right.
And I was the one who said, "Not so fast, baby." There was another one that was very compliant and was a real good girl. That's the one that kept her alive through all of the ups and downs. That's the one that she went back to, but it had no power. It was just like a bunch of morality. And then there was another one who really made all the connections with people, the boyfriends and stuff.
Is that a good personality or not?
It's actually a good personality, but it wasn't... It got...
hampered.
Mm-hmm. So which personality am I speaking to now?
Well, I'm still the blob, I'm still the energy, the leg.
Mm-hmm. Well, what personality is she displaying now? Which one does she use?
You know, I think they're all still there. She just isn't quite sure how to coordinate them.
Okay, good. Moose, are you done with her contract? The contract of being with her?
Well, I could cause more hurt, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I have no reason to stop.
Mm-hmm. Can I give you a reason to stop?
Okay.
Would you like to feel better?
Well, it doesn't bother me.
Mm-hmm. So, Moose, what I'm going to ask you to do is, even though you are a thought form, you come from consciousness, and that's every bit of consciousness has a spark of light. We all come from the divine. I want you to look inside of you, Moose, because you seem to be kind of dark now, don't you?
You could ask your father to pull me away.
Mm-hmm. But I want you first.
Okay.
To fill yourself up, because we want to be more light. Look inside of you, and I want you to find the spark of light, the one that created you. Look, it may be very dim, but it's there.
Hate created me.
Mm. I'd like you to fill that spot with light. I'm asking the divine to fill you with light.
Why?
So that you could feel what it's like.
Well, I don't care.
I'm asking the divine to fill you with light. I'm asking the divine now to fill you with light. I want it to go all through you, illuminate you, fill you with love. Tell me how you're feeling, Moose.
I don't have any power left.
Mm-hmm. Are you ready to disconnect from this woman now? And go to the light?
Can her father tell me to go to the light?
Of course. Would you like me to do that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. He needs to break the contract. So I'm going to count from 3 down to 1, and Moose, you stay there on hold, and I'm going to ask to speak with Russell. 3, 2, and 1. Allow me to connect with Russell. Good afternoon, Russell.
Hello.
Russell, it's my understanding that you made a contract with a dark energy. You created an energy of hate towards your daughter. Do you realize that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why did you do that, Russell?
Because her mother promised to help me raise the son. And the mother brought Jane in, and Jane was going to wreck the apple cart.
Mm-hmm.
Because she was too strong. I had to stop.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm angry at her mother.
Do you realize, Russell, you don't have a body anymore? You're not living in this life anymore.
Yeah, but...
Mm-hmm. Does Jane have anything to do with it, if you're angry at the mother?
Yes, because her mother brought her in to help her. And her mother brought in too strong. Jane's too strong.
Mm-hmm.
Jane's only fault was that she was too clever and strong.
Mm-hmm.
She didn't do anything wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But she was a threat.
She was a threat to you. Is she still a threat to you now, Russell? You don't have a body anymore.
Yeah, but my son is very successful.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a lot of people on my side.
Mm-hmm. When you say on your side, it seems like you have your own little war with her. What's going on there?
Well, I didn't figure on anybody getting in the way. I was told that I just could have this son and gain points in heaven with this son.
Mm-hmm. And are you in heaven now, Russell?
No.
And where are you?
I don't know.
You never made it, did you?
Huh.
Yeah. How are you feeling about that?
Well, I don't care because I have a lot of people on my side.
Mm-hmm. And who are these people? Are they souls?
Some of them are.
Mm-hmm.
They're like Cheney and Bush.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what? They betrayed me too.
Mm-hmm. How did they betray you?
Because I was never as successful as I was supposed to be.
What were you supposed to be, Russell?
I don't know. They just led me to believe I'd be a lot more successful than I was.
Mm-hmm. And you never made it.
I just didn't know how past a certain point.
Mm-hmm. You tried though, didn't you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But now you're stuck. You're stuck. You're neither here nor there.
Yeah.
And that can't make you feel good either, Russell.
Yeah, just kind of like in limbo.
Mm-hmm. Would you like me to help you today, Russell?
Well, I don't know what you can do for me, I mean.
Mm-hmm. Well, the thing that's holding you down is the fact that you have all of these things that you did to get you to where you are. You probably did a lot of harm to people, didn't you? On your way to the top. Did you cause any harm?
I really wasn't aware of it at the time. I didn't care if I did.
How about now? Now you're able to feel what you did to other people.
See, I told Jane that she... I let her know that I knew that she was really the bright one.
Mm-hmm.
So I could feel that much for her.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm really sorry I hurt my wife.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't mean to have to be so hard on her, but I had to get my way.
But what did that get you?
You're
in limbo.
Dead.
You're dead, right? You can't do anything now. Would you like Jane to forgive you for what you did to her? You've crippled her whole life. She could have been bright, she could have been successful, but you wanted your son to be successful. And now, everyone's gone, you and your wife. She doesn't even speak to her brother. How do you feel about that, Russell?
My vanity's hurt.
Mm-hmm.
I am able to feel.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit. Well, I guess I feel bad.
Mm-hmm.
I guess I feel bad.
Russell, are you willing to cut these cords from her body?
Yeah.
Everything that you did?
Yeah.
Go ahead and cut them.
Let's start over. Yeah.
Let's cut the cords from all of her body. Tell the muse, the one that you created with the hate, and any others that may be in her body because of you. I want you to go in there. Address them and tell them to cut the cords and cut the contract and they could go willingly to the light. Go ahead and tell them now.
Okay.
Do you see them, Moose? Do you see them, Russell?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How many are there?
Cords?
Mm-hmm.
a lot.
Okay.
It's like Capolini.
Mm-hmm. So let's pull all those cords out, Russell. Pull everything out and tell me what they look like.
Black tar.
Mm-hmm. Pull it all out. And are there any other energies or entities in there that you created?
No.
No, just the moose. Okay. So go ahead and tell him that you're breaking the contract.
It's finished.
Okay, good. Let me speak with Moose and I'll get back to you. Moose, how do you feel now?
Like a puddle.
Like a puddle. Okay, so I want to take that energy, that puddle, and I want you to go up through her crown, and I'm going to ask the angels of the light to encapsulate you, evaporate you, and take you into the light so that you can now be recycled into something positive. Tell me when you get there, Moose.
Okay.
Thank you. May the light of the universe accompany you. Thank you for helping. Let me speak with Russell now. Russell?
Yeah.
How does her body look now? Any cords left?
No.
Thank you. What would you like to tell Jane about what you've done to her all her life?
I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm. Let me speak with Jane.
Okay.
Jane, how does it feel now to have all of that out of you? Your dad cut all the cords.
Because I'm not in shock.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what I feel like now.
What would you like to tell your dad? He said he's sorry. Are you ready to let him go so that you don't have to be affected by him anymore?
Yeah, I always said that even on his deathbed, if he just turned to me and said, I'm sorry, that's all it would have taken.
Mm-hmm. You just heard him say, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Is that okay with you now? Are you ready to let him go?
I don't have to like him, though, do I?
No, you don't.
Okay.
You just have to cut the cord with him now.
Yeah.
And allow him to leave. All right, let me speak with Russell. Russell, how does it feel now? She's okay now.
Yeah, I know. It's funny when you feel kind of like floating when you cut a cord.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have anything to define you anymore.
No. Russell, I want to help you even feel even better. Would you allow me that?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm going to put my hand on your chest, and I want you to give to me all of the anger, all of the remorse, all of the negativity that you had, all of the power struggle that you felt, your whole family dynamics. Give it all to me. You don't need that anymore. Where you're going, you don't need that. Give it all to me so it could be healed. And tell me when I could take it.
Okay.
Very good. I'm going to send that to universe now, Russell. Now, in that space where you have taken all of that out, what would you like to put in there instead?
Love.
Let's put lots of love, like a fire hose. Let's fill you up with love and light. And let's seal that. What else would you like to put in there?
Compassion.
Lots of compassion. Very good. What else?
Let Jane know she's free.
Very good. Very good. So now, Russell, I'm going to ask the angels of the light to encircle you. I want you to feel their love. They're surrounding you now. And I'm going to ask Archangel Michael to accompany you and take you directly to the light. And there you'll see the others that are waiting for you, your guide and your teachers. And tell me when you get there, Russell. Very good. Thank you. May the light of the universe accompany you, Russell. And now I'm going to ask Archangel Gabriel to come in. He's the one who helps me with the healing. And I want him to fill her entire body with that beautiful, brilliant light that he uses. I want him to go through her whole body, seal it with light. Every place that there was a cord, an influence of any of these, just fill it with light. Completely with light. Feel all of the healing take place. Everywhere there was a connection. Feel it now, so that nothing else can enter. And tell me when he's done.
Okay.
Beautiful. May I speak to Jane's higher self now?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you very much for allowing that today. Why did you not show her any past life?
Because she knows, and if she doesn't know, she senses and will know.
Mm-hmm. So she already knows about her past lives.
Or she senses them.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Why did you bring her to the session today?
Because you know she still hurts.
Mm-hmm.
She has her moments, but then she feels she gets tripped up again.
Mm-hmm. Now, after what we've done today, do you feel that she's going to be able to accomplish what she came to here to accomplish? We don't have the influence of those beings and her father anymore.
It's what she needs. It's so much.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's so much.
Mm-hmm. May I ask where it is that she came from? Where is her home?
The light, she just came from.
She came from the light?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Has she ever lived here before?
Yeah.
She has, okay. Does she come from any particular planet or anything like that, or just from the light?
She just comes from the light and energy.
Okay. Is that why she's always felt that she's floating?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Why is it that she has felt all her life that she wants to go home? Is that her, or was that Kuz?
You know, it was both, but maybe the idea was Kuz.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You think she's going to feel different now?
Oh, yeah, she certainly understands now.
Good. Good. She had asked about the dark interference, and I think that we found them. But she wants to know if her soul can be cleansed of any contamination. Does she have anything in her soul?
You know, she still has little nicks and scratches.
Mm-hmm. And where are they from?
Just from feeling battered all around.
Mm-hmm. Can we heal those today?
Yeah, we have to round them out.
Okay, so let's do that for her today.
Uh-huh.
We want to give her a complete treatment. Now that we have all of those cords taken out of her, we need to make her feel good. And tell me when you're done with that. And are you using any particular light or energy for that?
I'm running energy up and down.
Okay, good.
But it'll take some time.
Okay, would you continue to work on her while she sleeps?
Yes.
Good. She told me that her astrology chart shows that she's always going to have trouble. Why is that?
Because she was headstrong and she thought she could take on anything.
Well, she seems to be very strong anyway. It's just the influence that she had that didn't allow that.
But she thought she could take on any dark energy and overcome it. See, that way she was a little, arrogant, maybe.
Maybe a little naive.
Naive. She took her strength and she played with it.
So what would you like to tell her about that now?
She doesn't have to test her strengths anymore.
Okay, good. She doesn't have to test the strength. Will she be better now?
She'll be smarter.
Good, good. Would you tell me what her dreams are telling her? She says she had a lot of airport dreams.
Those are all the sabotage.
Sabotage? Mm-hmm. From where?
Those guys.
Those guys? The influences?
Mm-hmm. And her father.
And her father. Okay. So were they kind of like trying to scare her with them?
Just trying to say, hello, we're still here.
Okay. So she doesn't need those dreams anymore.
No, actually, she can have a dream where she gets on the plane and flies off.
Very good. What about the underwater one? The one where she sees the dough and the women underneath. What's that about?
Oh, those are such gentle, gentle souls.
Mm-hmm. Who are they?
And they're staying alive under circumstances that would be impossible in the physical world. And they're fixing their gaze on her so she knows that the strength is with her.
Okay. Are they guides for her?
Yes, actually.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What would they like to tell her today?
That we are as beautiful as we look in that dream. And we will send you warmth and love.
Good. Beautiful. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
How is it that she gets these downloads about her past life memories?
Because she's tried everything available to her, like therapists and all that stuff, and nobody could reach it. Nobody could reach it, and she was never able to feel safe accessing. There was too much chatter in the way. She couldn't access her soul self, no matter what she tried to do. Chatter, chatter, clang.
Were these the influences that she had?
Yeah.
Which are gone now?
So she just exercised, just did enough exercises and started to trust what she intuited, that's all.
Okay, good, good. Would you tell her why it disturbs her so much to have her photo taken? When we first started talking with Coos, he was telling her how ugly she was. Is that Coos telling her that?
Yeah, and then...
What else?
It was... Shh.
she's not sure she has a soul or where it is.
Mm-hmm.
She's not sure if they're taking a picture of her soul
mm-hmm.
or her demons.
Mm-hmm.
She's not sure what they... She's not sure what's happening.
Mm-hmm.
She can't present her face to the world with any
mm-hmm.
joy.
Who was she seeing in the picture?
I'm sorry, say it again?
Who was she seeing in the picture when she looked at it? When she would see a picture of herself, who would she see?
Confusion. Just
confusion.
She just saw her confusion back at her.
Okay.
And she couldn't face it. It's bad enough to have it from the inside going out and then to look at it
mm-hmm.
on your iPhone from the outside going
in. Now, Moose was telling me that she had different personalities. Has she split off her personalities from herself? Are they... Did they run away?
No, they're still there. She's mm-hmm. just... been, she's done... She's really been able to integrate them.
Okay.
Mostly.
Can we do a little bit more of that?
Okay.
Let's have her pull. She's going to envision the little strings that are coming from her. And each one of those strings is going to take her to one of those sub-personalities that she has.
Okay.
And I want her to follow one of them and tell me which one she's following.
Okay.
Which one is that
it's
one?
It's the strong one.
All right. So I want you to pull that string and take it and put it back. And I want you to put it right into your body to integrate with you. Feel it just becoming one with you. And just take a deep breath as you do that and just have her breathe with you. Mm-hmm, very good. Just take a few deep breaths so that she can get accustomed to both of you being one. And now I want you to follow the other string and tell me who's on the other end of that string.
A good one.
The good one. Okay, where has she been hiding?
She's there. She's the one that helps Jane change her mind when she's made a bad decision. She's okay. Getting stronger.
Okay, so I want you to pull that string until it comes back into your body, and I want you to integrate her to where she melds completely with you, and then take another deep breath in so that she can start breathing as one with you so that you are complete with her. Feel the three of you now breathing together as one. And now I'd like you to follow the other string. And tell me which one that is.
The one where she has relationships.
Mm-hmm.
Her connection.
Her connections. Are these good relationships?
Yeah.
Very good.
Her heart is good.
So I want you to bring that string close to you, bring her in, and then I want you to integrate her into your body and just take a deep breath in and feel the heartbeat together with all of you now. Feel all of you integrating into one, melding into one. And I want you to just look around, scan, and see if there's any others that are straggling. Any other piece of your soul that may be hidden.
They're coming.
Mm-hmm. Good.
They're coming, okay.
Good. Is there any other piece of your soul that's been lost? Look all around.
She struggles with hope and
mm-hmm.
she feels a little smashed up in that area.
Okay, so let's do some healing in there.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead and put the light in there. I want you to do a beautiful healing session with light. And tell me what's being used.
I'm going to have to put it in little by little.
Okay, so let's do that. Mm-hmm.
Because she has to learn to trust.
Okay, very good. Put it in little by little. And tell me what it looks like as you're putting it in.
It's like an insertion, little insertion.
Mm-hmm. And where is this insertion going?
It's in her third eye.
In her third eye, very good.
But I would have to work on her.
All right, so continue working on her. And would you please work on her self-esteem so that when she looks at a picture of herself now, she can see the true being that she is. The beautiful, lit-up woman that she is. And allow her to see the beauty that she has from within.
Okay.
Very good. She asks about her fears. She says that she fears that she's going to be old and broke and alone, and she doesn't know how to die. Why is she getting these thoughts? Where are they coming from?
She just doesn't want another drawn-out or violent death.
Mm-hmm.
She feels her work is done already in this lifetime. She doesn't know why she's being asked to stay around, because her work is done. She feels she doesn't know why she...
Mm-hmm. Tell her why.
So she doesn't want to drag it out. She doesn't to drag out her life beyond its usefulness.
Mm-hmm. So tell her why she's still here.
Because she makes a difference.
Mm-hmm.
Even... it's so hard for her.
Mm-hmm.
She feels her work is done.
But it isn't.
I don't know after today. I don't know after today.
Mm-hmm. You feel that she's complete?
If this work today makes any difference, then maybe she has more to do. But if we didn't do this work, she would have been done.
Okay, good. So it's her choice.
Okay.
She can continue and help others now, if that's her choice.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. That's her free will. Good. Why has she spent so a lifetime of not being able to sleep? Who was messing with her?
She has a lot of memory of violent death.
Mm-hmm. Can you remove that from her so she can get some good, solid sleep?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful.
She knows.
Good, good. Just for fun, would you tell me why she's losing her glasses and things like that? What goes on there? We already talked about possible parallel lives.
Well, first of all, she needed new glasses, so I got rid of all the old ones by losing them before.
Okay.
And, but it's to help her build faith.
To build faith, okay. So to know that the glasses will come back?
Yeah, okay. And it all comes back. And if it doesn't, it's okay.
Okay, good. She says sometimes she feels like she's crossing dimensions.
Yeah, she is.
What? How does she do that?
I don't know. She's just not content to be in any one place. She's always looking. She's always exploring. She's, you know, she doesn't... Once she gets a read on a place or something, then she moves on it. It's so quick sometimes.
Do you have a hard time keeping track of her?
She doesn't stop, Naya. And then she feels she has an anxiety attack and then gets depressed. But she's beginning to suspect that now, that the depression is something about that.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't realize how much of her own free will goes into this, though. I mean, her own... choice to just like hop from one thing to another. It's because of the way she's built that she can.
Okay.
And it doesn't work in this world. This doesn't work in Miami. Doesn't work in New York. It doesn't work.
So she has a body that's holding her down. She'd rather be flying everywhere.
Yeah.
Okay, good. So it's not really a problem.
Nope.
No, it's just like what she does.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you give her a reading on her house? What's going on in there? She says she thought it was haunted, and we know that she had some bad juju in there. We had coups.
That's all true.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything else in that house?
House itself is fine, and the yard and everything and the barn is really exactly what her soul needs.
Mm-hmm. And what about the solar company?
But the
situation?
Nasty old people out in front.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, if that ain't a message. It's...
What's the message you want to give her about them?
If she chooses to make an opportunity that she doesn't have to be there anymore, she won't need any excuses to leave, because she's got it.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty much whether she chooses to move on.
Mm-hmm. Will you help her with that?
Yeah.
Okay.
And if she chooses to stay and she's okay with that solar thing, that's okay too, but it's all up to her choice.
Mm-hmm. She just has to make a choice to be okay with whatever decision she makes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Whether she stays or leaves.
Yeah.
Okay, good. What's going on with the birds and the bees and the butterflies that...
Oh, it's all this, you know, and it's these chemical companies, and then they... But you know what? Nature will triumph.
Mm-hmm.
They will all be back in a form that will be able to be okay in the world in the future.
Mm-hmm.
All of these clowns are going to trip themselves up.
Can you tell me more about that?
You know, we all need a guiding hand. And people who think that they can guide the guiding hand are ultimately only fooling themselves. And they're suspecting it.
Mm-hmm. Is this what the new earth is about?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So things are going to be changing pretty quick?
It'll take a while.
Okay. All right. But have faith. It's all coming back.
Well, you know what? I think we are wise to be prepared, because mm-hmm. we're in the hands of fools.
Okay.
They'll be back.
Okay, good. What about what she's supposed to be doing with her life and her career? What's she supposed to be doing? She wants to feel useful.
She's very well served to help other people.
Mm-hmm. In what capacity?
She... She can help read people.
Mm-hmm.
And just give them a glimpse of the bigger picture and permission to see the bigger picture, and people make the changes themselves.
Okay. Do you think that QHHT is part of it?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. It's a part of it. Might not be it, but it's a part of it.
Mm-hmm.
It'll be the basis.
Why did you lead her to QHHT?
Poor thing was suffering so much. The poor thing kept begging, and I'm sick of her cloying. She needed help.
She needed help.
And you know what? The genius that exists on this planet, I think I wanted her to partake in.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes she gets misled by a lot of things that are kind of a little wacky. So I wanted her to see the real deal.
Mm-hmm. And that's why she had so many sessions?
Oh, yeah, because every session led to something else, and she was putting the puzzle pieces together. It was like a kid. Yeah, she needed a lot of sessions.
Mm-hmm.
Like this one.
Well, this one is certainly not QHHT.
Yeah. She needed to have all that revealed so that she could get here.
Mm-hmm. So that was part of her healing, is to come here. Mm-hmm.
It was like we're at a big turning point for her. Big, big turning point.
Mm-hmm. Would you do a body scan on her, please?
Yes.
And tell me what you find.
It's her health is good, except for the darkness that we eradicated.
Mm-hmm. That seemed to have been causing a lot of the discomfort in the knees, the legs.
Yeah.
The shoulders.
It was the source of it all.
Mm-hmm. So she's pretty much in good health.
She's in good health. She needs to keep taking herbs.
Mm-hmm. Keep taking the herbs.
Keep taking the herbs.
Mm-hmm.
Not eat meat to the extent she can.
Okay.
She's better with fruits and vegetables.
Mm-hmm. How about water? How's she doing with that?
Not so much. She hydrates easily.
Good. Good.
She... You might find the beginning of cataracts.
Mm-hmm.
But not necessarily.
Mm-hmm. Can you put some light in there now?
Yeah.
Thank you. And continue while she sleeps. And what was the eruption that she had on her left shoulder? Was that a nerve ending or was that Kuz's past life?
Must have been Kuz.
Mm-hmm.
It was Kuz's wake-up call. Concerning cancer, I'm not sure how.
Mm-hmm.
It was a wake-up call. It got her attention.
Okay. Was it a good thing?
To wake her up the possibility of cancer, although she has nothing to be worried about now.
Okay, good. Why is she gaining so much weight?
She's treating herself.
What does that mean?
Food is such a comfort to her now for the first time.
Ah. Mm-hmm.
I'll let her know when she should kind of ease off on the high-calorie stuff.
Okay.
Although she eats well, but...
She eats well, but she likes to...
Yeah.
To give herself some treats.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Would you take a look at her back? She says it's very messed up from wear and tear. She wants to have relief there. What's causing that?
She takes out her frustrations by gardening and pulling weeds too hard and exercising too hard. Aggravates her back.
Okay. What would you like to tell her about that?
She calmed down. She doesn't have to have the aggravations.
Mm-hmm.
And she doesn't have to take them out. I'm... There's enough in the back to remind her to calm down.
Okay. Leave the rest of it?
Yeah.
Would you ask, will you find out what's going on with Jojo now?
Jojo had to leave.
Why is that?
She stayed beyond her time.
Okay. Helping her?
Yeah. But she didn't have it to do anymore. She didn't have any more strength.
Did JoJo have a contract with him?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What was the contract for?
She was cute. That she would be there for Jane and help her through the end of her marriage in the first 5 years.
Mm-hmm. And she seemed to have done a good job.
She did a very good doggy job.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything that JoJo would like to tell her now?
I'll be back.
In this lifetime?
Yeah.
Okay. What about Schnicky? What's the situation with Schnicky?
Just pure love.
Mm-hmm.
And now she's at George's, giving him pure love.
Mm-hmm.
And companionship.
Good. Is there anything that I should have asked that I didn't ask?
I don't know. What? Is there closure for Steve?
Mm-hmm.
Jane picked up that it possibly, when she was put out in the desert as an Indian, that he was her unborn child. And that was the connection in this life. To take care of him out of guilt. Can we let that go? We let that go.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, Jane has asked me to tell you that thank you for your help and loving guidance, and she has many moments where she feels very good and a true participant in her 3D life here now, and it comes and goes, mostly comes and says now, but this is new in the last few months, and she wants to thank you for the peace and comfort.
She's welcome.
Good. Do you have any message for anybody else?
Message for Patty.
Mm-hmm.
I hope she moves in her life. Jane hopes she moves in her life.
Okay.
And gets unstuck from her cancer. And the same with George. They're just right there. They just have to want to move.
Mm-hmm.
No matter what happens.
Can you send them the divine light to help them?
Yes, and Jane puts them both in light all the time.
Wonderful. Can we send some extra light today? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Wide awake now, feeling wonderful all over.
Wonderful and tired. You too.
How do you feel?
Oh my God. Wow.
What an experience, huh?
Yeah. I never thought.
Was it worth coming all the way from upstate New York for this?
Before I bought the ticket, I knew it would be.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Oh,
it was absolutely awesome. How long do you feel you were in this journey? How did it feel?
I don't know, like hour and a half?
Two.
Yeah, okay.
How did the selenite
work? Oh, I never let go. And then when you said in the beginning about how your hands merge with them, it's true.
Yeah, you felt like one block.
The whole time.
Feel like they grounded you?
Yeah. That's amazing. I'd never heard of these.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Really, nice, really nice.
Nice thing. So what was the most, most important part of it? What do you feel really, really was mind-blowing.
Getting the scoop on all that mischief going on in my body.
Yeah.
And where it came from.
Well, Kuz had a miserable ending to his life.
Yeah, that's a book in itself.
Yeah.
You know, to have to handle all those, you know. I just don't know. I've spent my life trying to normalize myself like I'm this American woman that should have been married and four children all, you know, in a suburbia already, and of course I am not and never will be. And so when I listen to things like this, I just go, well, God, no wonder, you know? I mean, if everybody had this, but I figured this out a long time ago, if everybody had all this shit going on, nobody'd get married and have kids, and they were like, the civilization would not go on. Oh, thank you so much.
It was awesome. So now, as being a practitioner, getting this from the other side, what do you think?
Well, here's what I think. God, the amount of work you did in keeping the characters all separated. That's the best social worker I've ever saw. I've ever seen. Family systems therapist, you are.
Your dad.
I got so many questions answered.
Yeah?
Even questions that I hadn't put on the question list about my father.
Mm-hmm. I mean, he was angry.
And how he drew me into it to get back at my mother.
Mm-hmm. And how he was so mad that he didn't become famous.
Yeah.
He wanted to be like Bush and Cheney, he said.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Didn't get there.
No, he drank too much, actually. He drank himself out of that. Although I'm not really sure that he was really slated to be a lot more than he was. But
he tried, though.
Boy, he had a good head start. I mean, he should give himself credit.
Yeah.
I don't think at that point in time, coming where he came from, he could have done any better.
Mm-hmm. And I could have gone further, but I was being guided not to continue.
That's fine.
Because there was a lot of dynamics we could have gone into, but my God, we would have been here for hours and hours.
Yeah, we would have. That's fine.
But that's what happens when you have a session. I'm kind of guided, like, no, don't go there. We're done. We're good.
It'll all come out, though, won't it? If it needs to.
Yeah.
It'll all come out somehow.
I think you're going to feel a lot lighter now.
and
you have to remember with this that you have had coups as part of your being since you were born.
Yeah.
So after this session, you may feel a little bit of grief or a little bit of emptiness because you're missing this part of you that was always there. It's almost like something's missing.
He really did. He was an important part of my personality.
And not a very good one.
Yeah.
Because he was causing a lot of mischief.
Yeah, but it was still part of it.
What about the three personalities that you brought in?
Yeah.
How did that feel?
It felt great, I'll tell you. As soon as I had had this dream that depicted them all, and I have the dream somewhere, I haven't reread it, and I gave them names, they all had names and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And then I had the claircognizance, you know, I had this kind of claircognizant thing when I was driving one day to put them all together and who they were. It was very... Just even that was answered so many questions, and I felt much better. My whole life felt better after that, even when I got out the car.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I noticed my handwriting changed, because that answered so many questions of my jumbledness. So what would happen is I would go on and I would get, you know, I did all this stuff and go to these practitioners and have these dreams, and I'd get these huge pieces. I say, great, this is it. This is the biggest piece of the puzzle, you know? And even today, this is the biggest piece of the puzzle, but it might not be. But each puzzle piece brought me to the next step so that I feel better and better and better. You know, I just feel more whole and complete.
When we brought them in, did you feel...
Yeah, it was cool. That was so nice.
It was good.
Yeah, so nice, yeah.
So... Do you recommend this to anybody else?
Of course.
And the magic question, would you want to share this?
Oh. No photograph.
So you want to block out your face?
No, it's okay.
It's okay?
It's okay.
Good.
So I can sit there and look at my face for 2 hours on YouTube.
You look so much happier.
I am. So do you. Actually, a lot of stress is out of your face, too. But boy, did you work hard. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. See, I suspected all this, all this intertwining.
Mm-hmm.
See, now I just feel so redeemed.
Mm-hmm.
And each time I stop blaming myself.
So are you ready to do this work full time?
I could do it full time. There's just like physically getting the room ready and...
So today we launch you?
We listen, I gotta learn. I don't even do Facebook, you know. Come on. That's all I could do to download Uber yesterday.
And you did it, and you got here.
I did.
So stay there. I'm gonna turn the light on.
Oh.
That's okay. Was rolling towards me.
Okay.
All right, so just sit up for me.
Mm-hmm.
Take this out because this is your recorder. You just sit up for me there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're going to get this out. Take a little bit further back. Great. All right, so we're going to sit here together. All right,
we're good.
Okay, so we just had a great session. Excellent session. And tell everybody where you're going to be working, where you're going to be doing your QHHT sessions. Where can they find you?
Well, currently I actually have done the sessions I've done in my home.
And where is your home?
In Salem, New York.
Salem, New York. Mm-hmm. So if you're near Salem and you would like a QHHT session, this was not a QHHT session,
right,
okay?
Right.
But
for me it would be.
But she will be able to do QHHT sessions for you if you're near Salem,
New York.
And she came all the way to Miami to have this great experience.
Oh yeah, I traveled. If people can travel. Listen,
if you want it bad enough, you can do it.
Travel.
Good. All
you
right.
Want the best to travel.
So anyway, if you want to find me, you can look me up at albaweinman.com. I have my website
mm-hmm.
there. Very easy to book,
mm-hmm.
like you did,
mm-hmm.
and we'll see each other soon. Bye.
Thank you.